So now that we have our products pretty much sorted out, what I want to do is I want to create a little sorted feature up here so that when we're in a category, we'll be able to sort through the products by price. Let's head into the text editor and start working on that. From here, we can head over to the shop index and then head down to, this will be the left side and this will be the right side where it's width 4/5. Right under the width 4/5, I want to add another div with the classes of flex, justify end, space x2, pt4, and pr4. And in here, I want to have a span with the class of font bold. And then in here, it's just going to say price. We'll come down underneath and we'll have two links. Well, we'll do one link for now. And in it, we're going to have an href that's going to be to the root shop index. Then we're going to have a class of hover text yellow 500. And in it, it'll just say low to high. So now we can take this and copy it. And then for this one is going to just say high to low, and let's just make sure that that's coming through. Cool, we see it here, and we have it here. Let's go ahead and restart the server and make sure that we're not missing anything. Let's try it again. Okay, and now we have our spacing a little bit better. Fantastic. The next thing I want to do is add a pipe in between this, so let's head back to the text editor. And in between these links, I'm going to add a span. And I'm just going to put a pipe in there. Okay, let's check that out. Now we have a little bit of a separation. Fantastic. Let's go ahead into our controller and then we can start pushing stuff to the front end page. Now we want to go to the shop controller, head down to the index function. And then in here, I'm just going to comment this out for now in case I need to use it for reference. Well, the first thing is we're going to still have if request category. Then we're also going to have another if, and I want if else, and I also want an else under here. Now this is going to say request sort. I'm sorry, this is going to be no request sort. So the first thing we want to have is the products variable, and we're going to say that equals product where has categories function, and in the function I'm going to put the query, and then we'll have query where slug quest category. Then we're going to have a get, and all we're going to need from that is the name, the slug price, and the image. I'm also going to put it in random order. And then after that, I'm just going to grab this one so I don't have to retype it. Where it's the same thing, it's a category name variable, and we're looking for the request category for the first name. And then I want to copy this one, paste it, and then I'm going to have another variable called category slug. Then we're going to be looking for the first slug. Now, this property is basically going to be pushing the slug into the view so that we can access it to click on the links that are going to those pages. I'll make it more clear once we get into it, but that's essentially what that variable is for. If request sort else, I will copy this one, I'll paste it in, and then we'll change it accordingly. We don't need this stuff here. Category name, and I also want to put for the category name up here, I want to make this optional. This way we don't throw an error if there's no category name. And the same for this one. Okay, this closing one should actually be here. Okay, and then we want to do the same for this one. Actually, this closing parentheses needs to be here, and the same with up here. Okay, now under this category slug, we're going to have another if statement. And we're going to say request if request equals low, high, then the products equals products order by price. And then we'll also, I can grab it from here. The same get that we're getting, we can get from in here. And then for the next one, it'll just be by default. And then this will be descending and everything else is good. So let's tackle this last else statement. In it, we'll say products equals product in random order, get, and then the category name equals all, category slug equals null. Okay, now let's also pass in that category slug down here. Okay, let's head to the browser and see if there's anything broken. So nothing's broken as of yet. We can still go to our categories and we haven't set up these buttons yet. So let's head back to the text editor and head into the shop page. We are going to go ahead and bring in that new property. Okay, and then we head back up to where the links are, and now we can pass in right here. Well, we can do both. We're going to be passing in the category, and we are going to be using that category slug variable that we just put in. We're also going to have a sort property. Okay, so low to high, we'll have low to high. High to low, we'll have high low. And then the other thing we also want to do is put vif category slug. So now let's head back and see if this works. If you hover here and look at the bottom left, right down here, you'll see that we have both of those parameters coming in and we are in the men's category. We'll try low. Okay, 23, 26, 52. And it looks like that's worked just fine. Let's try high to low. Okay, 98, 90, 89. Yep, that looks about right. Go to kids. Okay, now this is just displaying randomly, but we can sort it. Low to high, and it's displaying low to high. Same thing with high to low. Fantastic. One more thing we should check, and that's to make sure that on the shop page that we are displaying randomly, which we are, and we're not sorted in any way. It's just in random order. But we are getting everything. Fantastic. So that was one of the newer features that I've been adding along the way since we started this project. And we are going to be using Algolia for a proper search, and it's going to be an entirely different shop page altogether. I just wanted to show you guys how you guys would integrate something like that on your own. If you guys are enjoying the content, please go ahead and click that like button, as it really does help out the channel. I'm going to leave it there for now. I'm going to push all the code up to GitHub and leave a link for that down in the description, as well as the link to the playlist so you guys can catch up on all of the other episodes from this series. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.